follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. No turning back, no turning back.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Every crisis produces godly leaders. And today, both the readings are filled with the power and glory that how God prepares His godly leaders. Shall we then prepare our hearts? Are sorry for the moments we have failed to live with Him. I confess to Almighty God
and to my brothers and sisters that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, our Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive our sins, and lead us to eternal life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Grant us, we pray, O Lord, perseverance in obeying your will, that in our days the people dedicated to your service may grow in both merit and number through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Our reading from the book of Numbers, chapter 21, verses 4 to 9. From Mount Hor, they set out by the way to the Red Sea to go around the land of Edom. And the people became impatient on the way. And the people spoke against God and against Moses. Why have you brought us up out of Egypt to die in the wilderness? For there is no food and no water, and we loathe with worthless food. Then the Lord sent fiery serpents among the people, and they bit the people, so that many people of Israel died. And the people came to Moses and said, "We have sinned, for we have spoken against the Lord and against you. Pray to the Lord that he take away the serpent from us." So Moses prayed for the people. And the Lord said to Moses, "Make a fiery serpent and set it on a pole. And everyone who is bitten, when he sees it, shall live." So Moses made a bronze serpent and set it on a pole. And if a serpent bit any man, he would look at the bronze serpent and live. The word of God.
Thanks be to God.
Your response shall be, "O Lord, listen to my prayer and let my cry for help reach you."
O Lord, listen to my prayer and let my cry for help reach you.
O Lord, listen to my prayer and let my cry for help reach you. Do not hide your face from me. In the day of my distress, turn your ear towards me and answer me quickly when I call. Your response?
O Lord, listen to my prayer and let my cry for help reach you.
The nations shall fear the name of the Lord, and all the earth's kings your glory. When the Lord shall build up Zion again, and appear in all his glory. Then he will turn to the prayers of the helpless. He will not despise their prayers. Your response?
O Lord, listen to my prayer and let my cry for help reach you.
Let this be written for ages to come, that the people yet unborn may praise the Lord. For the Lord leaned down from his sanctuary on high. He looked down from heaven to earth, that he might hear the groans of the prisoners and free those who condemned to die. Your response?
O Lord, listen to my prayer and let my cry for help reach you.
Please stand for the gospel acclamation. I am the light of the world, says the Lord. He who follows me will have the light of life.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Chapter 8, verse 20 to 30. Jesus said to the Pharisees, I go away, and you will seek me and die in your sin. Where I am going, you cannot come. Then said the Jews, will he kill himself, since he says, where I am going, you cannot come? He said to them, you are from below. I am from above. You are of this world. I am not of this world. I told you that you would die in your sins, for you will die in your sins unless you believe that I am he. They said to him, who are you? Jesus said to them, even what I have told you from the beginning, I have much to say about you and much to judge. But he who sent me is true, and I declare to the world what I have heard from him. They did not understand that he spoke to them of the Father. So Jesus said, when you have lifted up the Son of Man, then you will know that I am he, and I do nothing on my own authority, but speak thus as the Father taught me. And he who sent me is with me. He has not left me alone, for I am always do what is pleasing to him. As he spoke thus, many believed in him. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear friends, today's first reading is from the book of Numbers chapter 21. Man's life is a mind game. Every time when God allows man to go through a crisis is to produce godly leaders who can take the challenges and who become witness on this earth with the power of heaven. Today's first reading we find that the people of Israel, they are walking in the desert. They have no food. They said, they cried. God gave them manna. But then they found it is worthless. The moment you are not satisfied with what God gives to you, the moment you begin to call what you have received from God for a mission as worthless, it's the sign for you that the enemy has entered into you. And they began to say that when we were in Egypt, we had cucumber, we had tomatoes, we have bread to eat, and here what? Morning manna, noon manna, night manna. What is this? My dear friends, when we face crisis, either we can feel helpless and join with the mob who are also doing the same chorus. We have nothing. We got plenty in Egypt. We can get back into the mob culture and looking for support and sing a song called What's Happening to Me? What's Happening to Us? Or in the moment of crisis, you can also ask what God is doing for us. Our life is the mind game. What type of question you raise in your mind will decide your life. Whether your mind can ask what's happening to us or what God is doing to us through what we are experiencing. The people of Israel, they had the mob culture. They went back, though they were moving towards Cana, physically, their mind was captured and they went back to their slavery where they were in Egypt. They went back, their hearts and longings were for the food they got in Egypt. And they preferred Egypt's slavery life than the life for which God is calling them. If you and I are not alert, the enemy, as 2 Corinthians 4:4 says, will attack our minds and our mind will go back to our slavery, go back to our sinful life, go back to find pleasures in the flesh and in the world, and we will lose sight of what God is doing to us. And that's what happened to the people of Israel. They forgot their God and they were saying, what's happening to us? We have no food and we are getting only this manna. And their minds slowly were captured by the enemy and they went back to slavery and they opened their doors to the enemy. And the enemy came in the form of snake and started to bite them. Because when they went back to their slavery, they began to say what they received from God as worthless. They began to call God's servant Moses waste fellow. And God himself is not worth having. The enemy's game is to take us back from God and to take us to destruction and death. On the other hand, to look unto the Lord, God is calling us. In every crisis, we can also ask, what is God doing to me? What is the Lord doing to our community? Means they can look unto the Lord, fill their minds with what God gives, with God's vision, and move with His word, and take up the challenge of the world, and face it with God's power, and knowledge, and grace. And then you will experience God's victory in the world. So God is calling us, and every crisis is calling us to leave the world and remain as God's witness. Yes. So every crisis can produce, number one, godly leaders. Second, challenge takers. Third, witnesses of earthly people living with heavenly power. That's what we read in the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 7. Verse 6 to 9, I chose you among this earth to be my people of my power. Yes. Now we find the Israelites when they were bitten by the snake, now God is calling them. They experienced God's call in verse 6 to 7. When they received God's consciousness because they were bitten by the snake, they returned back to Moses and they said, "We have sinned against God. Second, please pray to God. Number three, ask God to take away the snake from us." So whenever we go through the crisis, man begins to, his mind begins to work like this. How to come out of the problem? Instead of every crisis is calling us to get back to your God, to get back to your power, to get back to your strength. That's what we read in the book of Zechariah chapter 9 verse 12. Get back to your fortress. Don't roam around your weakness. Get into your strength. Every crisis is calling with clear, loud voice. Don't roam around your weakness. Get back to your strength to live. And now the people are, their calling is how to come out of the problem. So they are coming to God and saying, "Lord, we have sinned. Lord, please pray to God." Moses prayed to God. "Please take away the snake. Once the snake is gone, once again we will walk. And if there is problem, once again we will complain to God." God is asking, when are you going to have God? Praise the Lord.
Praise the
Lord. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So God is saying, "You make a snake, a bronze snake, and lift it up, because snake is sign of remembering one's own sin, its consequences. Having lost the power to which they belong to." Now God is asking them to do three things. Number one, repent for your sin. When you see the snake, you will remember your sin. When you see the snake, you will remember what is the consequence of sin that has led you to be killed. Your children are died. And when you look at the snake, you will also hear the cry of God saying, "Return back to your God." Yes, that's what we read in the book of Proverbs 28 verse 13. "He who covers up one's sin will not prosper." If you recognize your sin, repent for your sin, and you determine to leave away the sin, God's grace will enter into you. That's what we read in 2 Chronicles 7:14. "All those who come in my name, if they bow down, humble themselves, and acknowledge their sin, and give away their sin, I will forgive their sins from heaven. And I will empower them with my power from heaven. And I will heal their nations." Yes, still God is with them. God is calling them, "Come back to me. Now take a decision to move with God." My dear friends, in the gospel also, we read the same thing. In John's gospel, chapter 8, verse 12, which is the gospel acclamation today, "I am the light of the world. He who follows me," number one, they will not become victim of the darkness. Number two, they will have the light of life. So when we have the crisis, we can cling to the crisis and ask ourselves, "What's happening to me?" Or in every crisis, we look unto the Lord and say, "Where God is leading us to? What God is doing through us? What is the mission in which God is leading us to?" So he says, if you look unto me, if you follow me, I am the light of the world. So if you follow me, number one, I will protect you from the darkness. You will not fall into the trap of darkness. Number two, you will experience my life, my power, my vision for which you belong to. So every crisis is calling us to be alert, not to become victim to the enemy, means not to allow yourself to the mind game of getting discouraged or disappointed or speak the language of the enemy and being bitten by the snake, but rather look unto the Lord, take up the challenge and become men and women who witness to God, moving with the power and grace of God. So the Lord is saying, you will look for me and not move with me. This is the crisis we have. In John 8:21, today's gospel, Jesus says, you will look for me, but you will not move with me, and you will die in your sin. Many people come to God to look for God. They are coming to God that God should remove their crisis. God should remove their problem. Prayer means God helping them to come out of their problems. But God says prayer means being with God and knowing the purpose of God and surrendering oneself, offering oneself into the hands of God, that God may fulfill his mission in us. I repeat, man thinks prayer means coming to God and get the help from God and to come out of the crisis, come out of the problem. But God is saying prayer means coming to the Lord even in those moments of crisis and move with God. Means life is to be in the hands of God and allow God to teach us why this crisis, what is he doing in this crisis, and where does he lead us to, and to be in the hands of God and allow oneself into the hands of God to be used by God. So don't move with a thought of what you are going through, but rather move your mind to the thought of God, to the plan of God. Let heaven be part of you who are on this earth. I love to share with you this small incident which happened in 1 Samuel chapter 9, verse 19 to 21. Saul was searching for his donkey, and he goes to the prophet called Samuel. And the prophet Samuel says, God wants you to come and meet him tomorrow. And as for your donkeys, they are already met, and God will fulfill what is in your heart. What is in the heart of Samuel? He longs to be a king. He went around searching for his donkey, and he saw the beautiful land. He said, how can I be the leader? If I possess all these things, I can do this, I can do that. He was creating. He's a vision builder. God is looking for people, a vision builders. Who am I in the Lord? What I can do for the Lord? And God is looking for people who are vision, moved with visions, and God will use them. That's why the prophet tells, tomorrow you come, God will teach you, tell you what is in your heart. But as for your donkeys, which you are searching, it's already found. Don't hold on to the donkeys which are lost and lose sight of the destiny which God is preparing for you. The great vision God has kept for you. Let not the clouds of donkeys, the clouds of what we have lost in life, lose sight of what God has kept for us. The great destiny to be the king over the people of Israel. So God said to Saul through Samuel, what is in your heart? You long to be the king. Keep alive that vision. God is looking for people who are willing to take the challenge, who are willing to see God's light in darkness, who are willing to see what God tells us in this crisis, and move with God, move with the vision of God, move with the power of God, and bring God's power to this world which is dying, and lead the world with the power of God. And that's what we read in verse 23. Jesus says, John 8:23, "Hello, my dear, you are from below, and the worldly thinking is attacking you, but I am from above. I am bringing you godly thinking. Only with godly thinking, with the light of heaven, you can handle the crisis of this earth." And verse 26, he says, "He who sent me is reliable." So move with God. See, the Father sent me, and he is always with me. He has never left me, and he has been successful. So follow me. You will have never allow the darkness to overcome you, and you can enjoy the light which God gives to you. So move with him. Let not your life become crying how to come out of the problem, but how to move with God and bring God to this world. That's why in verse 29 he says, "My Father is always with me. He has never left me." In verse 28 says, "But when you lift me up, you will know that I give life even on the cross." You will lift me up. You will crucify me. But what the persecution or the problems one faces cannot stop me in giving life even on the cross. So the cross, the pain, the suffering the world gives to us cannot stop what God has designed for us. If we move with the light of God, if we move with God, yes, that's why Jesus says, when you are aware of the Father and when you move with my mission, you will overcome fear of death, you will fulfill God's purpose, and you will become a mighty witness. Yes, every crisis is producing godly leaders. Every crisis is producing people who take the challenges. Every crisis produces people who become witness to God, are bringing heavenly power to the earthly life and lead these earthly people with godly power. Let's close our eyes and surrender our life to him. When I am down, O my soul, why do you get so weary? When trouble comes, don't get upset. Remember, you have a God who raises you up. Move with him, and you are the one God has, and you can move the whole world. You are meant to rule the world. You are meant to be empowered by the Lord. Don't allow the spirit of fear, discouragement, or all that of the world to make you what it wants to be. It is ready to bite you with a snake. No, look unto the Lord. Repent for your sin. Return to God. Move with God. And be a witness to God. I'm down, and oh my soul so weary. When troubles come and my heart burden be, then I'm still and wait here in the silence, until you come and sit a while with me. You raise me up so I can stand on mountains. You raise me up to walk on stormy seas. I am strong when I am on your shoulders. You raise me up to more than I can be.
You raise me up so I can stand on mountains. You raise me up to walk on stormy sea.
I am strong.
I am strong
when I am on your shoulders.
When I am on your shoulders.
You raise me up.
You raise me up
to more than I can be.
To more than I can be.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah,
hallelujah.
Together with this bread and wine, let's surrender our lives to God, that we can move with God to move the world.
Take a breath, we ask you, take a heart. We love you, take our lives. Oh Father, we are yours. We are yours. Take a breath, we ask you, take a heart. We love you, take our lives. Oh Father, we are yours. We are yours. Yours as we stand table you said, yours as we eat the bread our hearts can't forget. We are the sign of your life in us today. We are yours, we are yours. Take a breath, we ask you, take a heart. We love you, take a life. Oh Father, we are yours.
Pray, friends, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and good of all His holy church.
We offer you, Lord, the sacrifice of reconciliation, that being moved to compassion, you may both pardon our offenses and direct our wavering hearts through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord, for the days of His saving passion and glorious resurrection are approaching, by which the pride of the ancient foe is vanquished and the mystery of our redemption in Christ is celebrated. Through Him the host of angels adore your majesty and rejoice in your presence forever. Holy, 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 holy Lord,
God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which is given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for all, so that your sins may be forgiven. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Thuma Balavar Archbishop, Govind Joji our patron, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Let's pray for those who are offering today's Mass. We pray for the world, the crisis that God has given to us through Corona. We will overcome it and bring forth God's power. We pray for those who are sick, those who are suffering. May the healing power of God through this Eucharist enter into them, casting away the evil, casting away the sickness, and bringing forth God's healing, God's anointing, and God's glory. Through him and with him and in him, God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours. Forever and ever.
Amen.
Let's pray with confidence to the Father the words our Savior gave us.
Our Father in heaven, holy be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be
today, our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Do not bring us to the test, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power and the glory are yours,
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, My peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let's offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
This is the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are we who are called to take part in this meal of love.
Lord, I'm not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. My way, Jesus, you are my way, Jesus, you are my way, you are my King, I worship you, you my true Jesus, you are my true Jesus, you are my true, you are my King, I worship you, you are my true.
I am lifted up from the earth. I will draw all to myself, says the Lord. Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that ever seeking what is divine, we may always be worthy to approach these heavenly gifts through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let's go to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.